this time we ask you to please silence all cell phones and noise-making devices. If you must leave during the performance, please leave in between pieces during the applause. Lastly, any unauthorized audio or video recording is strictly prohibited. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
composed by Chinese American composer Chen Yi, who is the professor at UMKC. And this piece was written in 2013 and commissioned by the Oregon Arts Council. And because Chen Yi was born in China, so basically his composition style is a combination by using the Chinese traditional material and the Western compositional style. So in this piece, you can hear a little bit the kind of like Oriental style. And also, this piece is so different from the other her composition because it's all about imagination because it's talking about the northern things. So I'm going to read a short sentence. Basically, it's her inspiration about this piece. In the north, the vast and magnificent blue mountains, boundless, desolate, and indistinct. So she's using a lot of pedals, so you can hear lots of nuances. It's really kind of romantic eyes, and then it's just your imagination. You hear the sounds, especially in this fabulous acoustic hall. So I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you. We started the program, we hit the floor running with the Sudeberg. The whole recital kind of spawned about a year and a half ago. We did this over in Troy, but we had a voice faculty, and we actually opened the recital something a bit lighter. We did some Scarlatti arias, and then segued, you know, worked into the Sudeberg, and then ended with a Kennan. And unfortunately, that voice faculty has moved on to another institution, and so we had to scratch our heads and go, what, you know, and substitute it with one of the wonderful solo work you just heard. But what that meant is we hit the ground running with the Sudeberg. But it's a fantastic piece. We really enjoyed working on it and performing it. Originally, that piece for me started many moons ago. I'm originally from Boston, and so I grew up heavily influenced by Charlie Schluter. I was fortunate to get some lessons with him. And not to date myself too much, but at one point when I was in high school, I heard on the public radio station he was going to be doing a live broadcast. So at the time, try to imagine this, long before YouTube and all this other stuff, I got my cassette deck and I put a blank cassette in there, and it was fancy because it had a timer. And I was able to put a timer on and say I wanted it to record it. So I was able to record this live broadcast while I was off at school. It was the best thing I ever did, because the Sudeberg and the Peasley Night Songs were the two pieces that Charlie Schluter performed that day live on public radio. And that was the first time I heard the Sudeberg, and fell in love with the piece. I subsequently heard Charlie Schluter perform it live a few times. I heard the composer was on faculty at a little tiny liberal arts college in Western Massachusetts. I saw him speak about the piece, and really loved the piece, and was determined to do it on one of my student recitals, and it just never worked out. For a multitude of different reasons, it never worked out. And so that piece lay in my stack of music, and finally, a year and a half ago, I pulled this out. I am going to get you, Sir Sudeberg, and I finally had the opportunity to perform that piece. So that's where that one came from. And then this next work, of course, the trumpet players here are probably well aware of the Kent Kennan Sonata. It's one of the war horses of the sonata repertoire for trumpet. I try to revisit the big concertos and sonatas every few years. And the last time I visited the sonata prior to performing it a couple of years ago was my master's recital. So now again, not to date myself too much, but it was time to pull out the Kennan again. I really do enjoy coming back to the standards and the repertoire, because I think many of you will find when you perform it once, that's great. You perform it again and you go, huh, I didn't even notice that. And then every time you have another performance of some of these great works, you find more and more about it, and that has definitely been the case with me.